हेलो फ्रेंड्स स्टूडेंट्स नमस्ते। बिफोर इन फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर पार्ट वन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शन डेफिनेशन, लिमिट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शन, एनालिटिक फंक्शन, डिफरेंशिएशन एंड कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शन एंड सीआर कंडीशन अबाउट एनालिटिक फंक्शन। सो हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सम स्मॉलर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ limit of complex function and analytic function, and then in next lecture we are discussing about the necessary and sufficient condition and theorem. So here evaluate limit z tends to infinite 2z plus 3 upon z plus I. So here the example of limit, here limit is given z tends to infinite, and here if we are putting at the place of z infinite, then we are getting the z by z form. So we replace here in this form by taking common of z from both denominator and numerator. So here z take the common, so 2 plus 3 upon z remains, and also here z take common 1 plus I by z. So here we are taking the z common from numerator and denominator, and both z are cancel out. We are taking z common because here z, because of this z we are getting the answer of infinite at both sides. So take common, here we are getting 1. So now if we are put infinite at the place of z, then we are not getting the form of infinite by infinite. So we are take the z common, z cancel out. Now we put the limit, there are no problem. So the 2 plus 3 by infinite means 0, and here the 1 plus I by infinite, which are means also 0. So these two both are 0, so we are getting the 2 plus 0 upon 1 plus 0 and get the answer as 2. So this one is the easy question about the limit of complex function, and we are given the answer 2. In first lecture we are discussing also about the analytic function. And about the condition of analytic function, and by using that one condition of analytic function we are discussing here the example. The analytic function condition is the del u by del x equal to del u del v by del y, and second one is the del u by del y equal to minus del v by del x. These both one are the condition of necessary condition of analytic function. Here z is equal to u plus iv. Here the u is the function of xy and v is also the function of xy. Now we are going through the example. Here the given example, first example is prove that exponential of z is analytic. Prove that exponential function of z is analytic. Here exponential function z given, so we can write down the f of z equal to function exponential of z. Exponential function of z, so e raised to z. And here z is a complex function. Z is the complex function. We are taking two variables x and y. So e raised to x plus iy. E raised to x plus iy, because z is equal to x plus iy. X plus iy. Okay. And f of z equal to u plus iv. So e raised to x plus iy, which one we can write down that f of z equal to e raised to x into e raised to iy. Here, power, which one given we are separate, e raised to x plus are converted into e raised to iy. So, e raised to x into e raised to iy. Now, e raised to x into e raised to iy, e raised to iy, which one? We can write that e raised to iy, here I is in the power. So, we are converted in trigonometric that e cos y plus I into sin y. Which one we are discussing in the SY, e raised to iy equal to cos y plus I sin y. So, e raised to x, at the place of e raised to iy, we are put cos y plus I sin y. Multiply both the term by e raised to x, so e raised to x into cos y plus I e raised to x into sin y. Here friends, this one the value of f of z, and also the f of z equal to u plus iv. F of z equal to u plus iv. So comparing on both sides, we are getting this one is the value of u, it means the real part, and this one is the value of v, it means complex part, imaginary part. So this one is the imaginary part, and this value is the u, it means the real part. So now we are getting the u equal to e raised to x cos y and v equal to e raised to x into sin y. Now with the use of CR condition, we are differentiate u with respect to x and y and differentiate the value of v with respect to x and y. Now del u by del x, it means we are differentiate with respect to x. So the cos y is taken common constant. So e raised to x cos y into e raised to x derivative. So e raised to x into cos y. Similarly, del u by del y, in which we are differentiate with respect to y, so the e raised to x is taken common, it means the constant. So e raised to x takes common constant, cos y derivative minus sin y. So we are getting del u by del y equal to minus e raised to x into sin y. Second, v. So del v by del x equal to sin y is the constant, and e raised to x derivative, it means e raised to x. We can write directly e raised to x differentiate with respect to x is e raised to x. Now, second one, del v by del y, so e raised to x is the constant, and differentiate of sin y with respect to y, it means cos y. Differentiation of sin is the cos plus, so e raised to x cos y. Now, we can check about CR condition. So here, del u by del x is equal to e raised to x cos y. Similarly answer, e raised to x cos y, del v by del y. It means del u by del x equal to del v by del y. CR condition satisfied. Here, second one condition is del u by del y equal to minus del v by del x. Here sign difference is available, here plus and minus. So we can write down del u by del y, del u by del y is equal to minus del v by del x. And if CR condition satisfied, then we can say that the f of z is analytic function. F of z is analytic function. So here, so friends, we are discussing two examples. First one is the limit of complex function, and second one is about the analytic function. And in the analytic function, we are only discussing about the CR condition. Next example of analytic function, because friends, we have given so many large examples of analytic function. So we are discussing about two examples of analytic function in this video lecture, part number 2. So that f of z equal to next if f of z, yes, example, if f of z equal to x square plus ays plus dy square plus I into x square plus 3xy plus dy square is analytic function, then find out the constant ABCD. Find the value of constants A, B, C, and D. Okay. So in this example, friends, firstly we are given that f of z is analytic function. F of z is analytic function. So we can write down directly that CR condition for given function is satisfied. And from that scenario, f of z satisfies analytic function condition. So by use of CR condition, we are finding the constant A, B, C, and D. So we can write down that if f of z is analytic, function, then CR condition holds it or satisfy. CR condition satisfy. So with the use of CR condition, we can write down this one is the real part, and real part of f of z equal to u, and if u equal to x square plus ayx plus by square. And imaginary part of f of z, it means v, and v equal to x square, which one is with I, x square plus cxy and plus dy square. Now del u by del x, differentiate with respect to x and y. Del u by del x, it means x square derivative, which one we are getting 2x. Power comes down and 1 power is deducted from this value. So we are getting 2x. Plus here a and y both are constant because we are differentiating with respect to x, and del x by del x 1. And here all the term is constant, so we are getting 0. Second, del u by del y. We are differentiate this real value with respect to y. X square is the constant, so 0. Plus ayx, in which ax is constant because we are discussing about differentiate with respect to y. So 1. And plus dy square derivative. So b is constant and y square value is 2. So 2by. This one is the first, this one is the second derivation. Now we are discussing about derivative of v. So del v by del x equal to x with respect to x. So x square derivative 2x CXY, in which CY constant, S derivative we are getting 1, and DY square is totally constant, so 0. Equation number 3. Now, last derivation, V with respect to Y, equal to x square is the constant because with respect to Y, CXY in which CX constant and derivative of Y1 plus D is the constant and Y square derivative is 2Y. Equation number 4. Now using CR condition, we can write down that equation number 1 and 3 both are equal because del u by del x equal to del v by del y, equation number 1 and 4. So, because del u by del x equal to del v by del y, which one? The condition of CR condition. Put the value, del u by del x value is 2x plus ay, and in opposite side, del v by del y value is tx plus 2dy. By comparing on both sides, here the cx, here the 2x. So, we are getting the value of c is equal to 2. Now, comparing the second term, here is the a and here is the 2d. So, we getting relation between a and d, a is equal to 2d. Now, completely CR condition we can write down directly by equation number 2 and 3 both are equal. So, we can say that del u by del y equal to minus del v by del s because here sign changes are necessary. Put the value del u by del y is the ax plus 2by minus and del v by del x is the 2x plus 3y. 2x plus 3y. Comparing on both sides and also taken this minus nisani, it means the minus sign. So minus 2 equal to a. It means a equal to minus 2 and 2b equal to minus c because this minus sign is also given to this term. So 2b equal to minus c. Now c is equal to 2. So we can place this 2 at the place of c and getting the value of b, the minus 2 because value of c is equal to plus 2. 2 cancel out and we are getting the b equal to minus 1. Now a value minus 2, b value minus 1 and c value 2. Here a, so put the value of a and we are getting the value of d. So a is equal to minus 2 equal to 2d. 2 cancel out and d equal to minus 1. So a equal to minus 2, b equal to minus 1, c equal to plus 2 and d equal to again minus 1. This one is the answer of all these constants. It means in this example we are only getting the real part u and imaginary part v. Differentiate u with respect to x and y. Differentiate v with respect to x and y. Comparing the CR condition and by explanation, we are getting the find A, B, C, and D constant. Jai Hind, Namaste.